Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm doing my November favourites for you all, which is so exciting because it's now almost December, which means Christmas time and New Year's parties, and then after in January, it's my birthday, so I'm so excited. It's a very exciting couple of months ahead. First favourite I'm going to talk about is what I've used on my eyes today to create this eye look, and it is my Lorac Mega Pro Palette. This, if you can get your hands on one, I would absolutely recommend it. You all know I love my Lorac Pro palette. It was just one of my favourite purchases I've ever made. But this little beauty, it's just like the Lorac Pro on crack. I absolutely love it. It's the same deal where you get like half the palette is matte and half the palette is shimmer. But just look at those colours. Ooh, they're so beautiful. So the top two rows are matte, bottom two are shimmer. And what I loved about this palette was that you got a little bit of variety of sort of colours. Like you get all your cool neutrals and stuff as well, but there are those like pops of the mulberry colour. There's a beautiful grey, there's a deep teal, indigo, with like which is like a really pretty kind of shimmery purple. You just get a little bit more colour variation than the Lorac Pro original. But it's that same beautiful quality, and yeah, so I did this eye look today, which I really loved, using all those kind of cranberry orchid shades. So I thought it was really cool. The packaging's nice as well. It's that same kind of very thin cardboard. It gets really dirty, but that doesn't bother me because it looks like it's well loved and used that way. But yeah, very good for travel because it's very slim, but you can get heaps of selection, so you could like go away for a month and you could do different eye looks every day. My next favourite beauty item is two cheek products from Illamasqua, and these are two like cream, one's a cream blush and one is a cream highlight. I have talked about these before on my channel. This one is the colour Dixie, which I've been loving this spring. A very natural looking flush, and because it's cream too, it blends in beautifully. It doesn't look like you're wearing blush, but it just gives you a healthy glow, so I've been adoring that. I use my Real Techniques stippling brush to apply this on. So this is my Illamasqua highlighter in Aurora, which is just a beautiful, soft, shimmery champagne. I've called this colour Gleam before on my channel, and I mistakenly read like that's what the type of product's called, like a Gleam highlighter, but the actual colour name is called Aurora. It's very confusing, but it's the same one I've always had, and I just love this for a very dewy, glowy look that doesn't look over the top. It looks a lot more natural than a powder, so for springtime, summer, I just always reach for cream highlighters. For lipsticks this month, I've been keeping very sort of neutral, as you can tell by what I'm wearing today, but sort of that very mauvey, plummy, neutral kind of lip. The one I'm wearing today is Syrup, which you know I love this lip colour. This has got quite a sheen and shimmer to it, so it's a little bit more like glossy than this other one I'm going to show you, but I thought it just went really well with this eye look today. That's why I'm wearing it. But yeah, I have loved that and really killed that this month, as well as this lip combo, which you saw in my recent Simple Work makeup tutorial. If you haven't seen it, just have a look on my channel. It's where I could link it. If I have time, I'll link it. But the combo is MAC Lip Liner in Soar, which is just a very nice kind of nudie Kylie Jenner lip colour. And then the one that I've been putting on top of that is MAC Brave. And this is quite... it looks so similar to Syrup in the like tube, but this is a satin finish, so it's not as sort of lustery and shiny. It's a little bit more sort of like demi matte, you know, like it's a satin, so it's got that sheen, but it's not glittery or shiny as such. It's just very natural looking, and I absolutely love it. This was a recommendation from one of my good friends, Amelia Berry. If you're watching, Amelia, thank you for recommending this because I love it. So you need to go buy Syrup, because I've told you to buy that, and I think you'll love Syrup if you love Brave. And I apologize in advance for making you poor. My next favorite is a skincare product, and this is the Elemis Fresh Skin Super Boost Moisturizing Serum. I love Elemis skincare, especially the serums. They're just quite affordable serums, but they're very like packed with really good ingredients for my skin. I buy serums for moisturizing reasons, basically. Like, I want my serum just to give me that extra boost of hydration, but it's not like it's different to emollient like moisturizers. Like, it's not going to break you out or anything. It's literally just packed with hyaluronic acid, vitamin E, like just really good stuff for your skin. And it's just, yeah, quite a decent size. I think you get 30 mils, and obviously you only need one little pump of this because it's a serum, so it's quite lightweight. And I apply this under my moisturizer morning and night, and I love it because it just It really helps to target my dehydrated skin if I'm not drinking enough water in there. It just gives it that extra boost and glow to my skin, and I think my skin's looking pretty good at the moment. I buy this off Feel Unique or Look Fantastic, just depending on which site has it in stock at the time. My next favourite is a nail varnish, which I think is hilarious because I'm not very into doing my nails, as you can tell, because I'm a violinist. But this is what I've been using on my toes all month and I have loved it. It's a very kind of neutrally pink, like, okay, no, it's like candy floss pink, but I feel like this kind of colour on my toes works with all the sandals I have and all the outfits that I wear, so that's why I love using it heaps on my toes. It is the OPI Nail Polish in Mod About You, and this is such a classic favourite, like cult favourite polish. It's a very chalky pink, so it's very like opaque. It's not that sheeny kind of sheer pink that you sort of put on, you're like, what? Where is the colour? This actually looks like what it does in the bottle on your nails, which I love. So it's a very, it makes you look more tanned than you are as well, which is always a bonus if I'm so pale. So this one is such a great polish. It looks good on my fingers and nails as well, but I just simply don't have the time or can't be bothered maintaining fingernail polish because, let's face it, they're just like little stumps that, you know, they have to stay that way because otherwise I can't press down the strings well on my violin, and my violin's more important to me than nice fingernails. So if you're in the market for a cute nail polish for summer and spring, then I would definitely grab this one because it's such a classic. My next favourite is hair products, and let's just start by saying that my hair is like my favourite of the month. I have been adoring my hair, my new change of colour. I love the shorter length. Like, I never thought I would enjoy my hair shorter because I was a bit sad that I had to get it cut off to bleach it. But oh my gosh, it's like a liberation. Like, I thought my identity was in my very long hair, but really it was just kind of wispy and nothingless at the ends, and it didn't look healthy, and now my ends look all, like, I look bouncy and voluminous and healthy, and there's a real, like, look at the gloss in my hair, like, it's so, oh, I love it. So I'm obsessed with my hair colour. I really, really love it. And I got this done a few weeks ago by Anthony David at Rocky Bunny in South Melbourne, which is a fantastic salon. They've won lots and lots of awards over the years, and he's the like technical director of colouring there, and so I paid extra money for him and it was absolutely worth it because he has just done such a good job. It's sort of like a nice ombre from a sort of, yeah, chocolatey brown to like a beautiful warm coppery colour, and I just think it's really cool. I will be going lighter again in a few months time, but I'm just enjoying this hair colour for now, this sort of intermediate hair colour. Anyway, what I've been using on it to protect it, obviously because I'm bleaching my hair, you've got to like use even more protection. So I used to be really bad at using heat protecting sprays, like I just couldn't be bothered, so I never would, and that's obviously really bad for hair. So, you know, I won't ever do it again, don't worry. But I have been using the Toni & Guy Heat Protection Mist, and I found this to be really good. Like, I don't really know, at the time you don't really notice if it's doing anything or not, but it has, like, my ends, I haven't got split ends yet, and I was pretty stoked because it's been a few weeks, and generally after I've had a cut, after a few weeks my hair already starts to get split ends. So I think because I've been using this before heat styling, both blow drying and straightening or curling, I think it's really made a difference because my hair definitely isn't as broken. So this one's really cool, and you can buy it from supermarkets. It's about $16, so it's not like a cheap spray, but it's not like super high end. But this product is probably even more of a favourite. It was a bit of a random purchase. I think there was a deal on with the Toni & Guy products, so I just bought a few. I got a mousse as well, which is like, meh. But this is an amazing spray. This is their Rough Texturizing Spray. It's for disheveled matte finish, which I love because, I mean, my hair is very shiny because it's quite healthy at the moment, but at the roots and throughout the lengths, I love to put this in after I've curled it to kind of give it a bit of pieciness. So my curls look a little bit sort of not so perfect, and it really helps to just give a kind of cool bedhead sort of effect to the roots and kind of plumps up the volume a bit. So it's just a really cool, like, all round product. You can kind of make your hair look a little bit messy but really styled. So I love this as well. It's about $16 again from the supermarket, so not too pricey, and just a little fun product to kind of, I've never really used products like this, so I was very impressed by what it could do. My next favourite is a pair of flip-flops. also known as thongs in Australia, not to be confused with G-strings, and in New Zealand we call them jandals, and they're like this. But these ones are special jandals. These are from Mi Piace, and they've got really big bling straps. And these are my favourite jandals of all time. I've already had a pair in the past that I have every few years, and they were just absolutely trash, so I went and bought another pair because they still had them in stock, and I was very excited. They are so comfortable, but you can wear them like casual, but dress them up as well. Like I wear them with maxi dresses and it can look very dressed up. I've even worn these in a music performance under a gown. It was for the National Concerto competition and I was like, I really want to wear heels when I'm playing because I like to be very stable when I'm standing up to play. And I was wearing a long gown and I was like, Mum, I'm totally wearing my jandals in this because it just, the light will catch the sparkles and you probably won't even notice they are like sandals, so it was quite funny. They were very comfortable and I ended up doing very well in that competition, so maybe they're my like lucky jandals or something. And I have two favourite YouTubers from this past month. They've actually been my favourites for like a couple of months now. I just have really enjoyed watching their videos, and when a new video comes out I get really excited seeing them in my subscription feed, and I'll sort of like skip past other people to watch theirs, which you used to watch very systematically, like I would watch next person, next person, next person, but now I sort of like hunt through, watch the ones I want to watch first and then maybe go back and watch other people's after. But I love, 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 love Viviana Does Makeup. So Anna from Viviana Does Makeup is amazing. Like, her videos are just so inspirational to me. I love her style. It's very like classic and clean and polished and not too like fluffy and like over the top. I guess she's just been a huge inspiration for me on what I would love to do with my channel. So she also has an amazing blog as well, so she always kind of like has extra information on her blog and her blog posts, so I enjoy it in the mornings like with my coffee reading her blog, and then later in the evening I'll watch her videos and they're just so informative. And she's really big on like skincare and that as well, so I love that because I really care about my skin and I feel like you can only have good makeup if you look after your skin underneath it. So I just get really excited when her new videos come out and they're always very entertaining, and I love her weekly vlogs as well. I love seeing like what she does in her, like when she's not filming, and it's just very entertaining. You'll sort of start to think like she's like your sister, like she's just very personable and I feel like I relate to her so well through the camera. It's really dorky, but she's awesome. So definitely check her out, I'll link her channel below. Oh, you probably have already heard of her or watched her or are subscribed to her, but if you're not, her channel is linked below. And the other person I've been really enjoying as well is Rachel from Rachel Lee. I'll link her channel down below as well. Rachel is such a sweetie. Like, she's an Australian beauty guru and I think she lives up in the Gold Coast now. She used to be from Canberra, but I've been watching her for probably like a year-ish, maybe a bit longer now. But she is just really cool, really down to earth. She does some very interesting makeup looks with lots of colours and stuff as well, and she does like celebrity inspired videos. I really liked her Taylor Swift videos that she's been coming out with lately. That was very cool. And I also really love her Q&As. They're always really funny. And my last favourite for you, which I am so excited to show you guys, like this is insanely exciting for me. I'm gonna die. Like, oh, okay. It's Toothless. I have been on the waiting list for this Toothless toy from Build-A-Bear for 4 months. I have waited 4 months for you, my dear. I love him so much. He is just so cute. And look, he comes with like little wings and he's got his little tail. Do, do, do. Toothless the dragon. My name is Toothless. I am cute. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I love him so much. So yeah, I just want to show you guys this because he's going to be sitting in and on my videos a lot. If this is the first time you've watched one of my videos, you probably don't know that I am obsessed with How to Train Your Dragon, the whole movie series and the TV series that go along with it. And I have wanted to build a bear toothless toy for ages, so I was on their waiting list and they finally called me so I can finally go get one. And the best thing about him is I paid the little bit of extra money to get a beating heart put inside of him. So if you click it, I don't even think you'll be able to hear it, but basically it's like boom, 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 boom. And his whole body like vibrates with like a heartbeat, which is so cute because it's like you're alive. So cute. I snuggle with him at night, and Mr. Morton is a little bit like jelly, isn't he? He be jelly. It's because you're so cute. But you can take his wings off as well, because his wings are a bit scratchy, so I take them off at night when I cuddle him. So yeah, so excited. So that's it for my favourites today. Don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up if you did enjoy it, especially for Toothless. Give me a thumbs up, yeah, I deserve it. And make sure you subscribe as well, because I do make weekly videos, and I would love you to be part of my family here on YouTube. So until next time, see you and have a good week!